So today we are gathering for getting some basic idea in IoT, especially for mechanical and electrical engineers. Basically, IoT is an emerging field. You people know about today we are gathering value of IoT in future. Some basic idea.
Some people may not even know what
IoT
is the
basic, especially for
behind the IoT
mechanical.
So
and
the
electrical
scope of this lecture,
I'm going to explain what is IoT and how we can make the framework for IoT to earn any device. That is the purpose of this lecture. Basically, I'm going to start with history and then we'll go.
Good morning to all. It's my great pleasure to welcome you to the technical webinar on the topic of need of IoT for modern electrical and mechanical engineer. On the behalf of Triple E Department, SCAD College of Engineering and Technology, I extend a very warm welcome to our resource person, Mr. K. Satyamurthy, Assistant Professor, SRM Institute of Science and Technology, Chennai. I welcome you, sir. And also, I welcome all the professors, research scholars, and students from various engineering colleges. Now, I like to hand over the session to our resource person. Please, sir.
Thank you, Firmness. He is my very close friend from our college. So it is very happy to me to give the present in front of everyone. I thank all the organizers and participants to coming for this lecture. So these are all contents are available in this lecture. We are going to start with the basic definitions of IoT. Then we are going about what about the importance of IoTs and how we can make traditional devices into IoT devices and what is embedded system and applications of IoT, some case studies like that. So I had I have some experience on IoT during the students project. I have done two projects in IoT. So these two project, I can explain about how we can run the project using the IoT. So all the people, those who are doing the research or starting the career in engineering field, should know about the emerging trends of IoT. So IoT is available in everywhere, but mostly we don't know where it is IoT. Okay, so let me start with the basic definitions of IoT. So in the IoT means nothing but it is the Internet of Things. Okay, so it have an infinite definitions. The name itself having the meaning, the Internet of Things means nothing but how the things can communicate with each other. Okay, for example, the car, here one car is given, so car can communicate with either another object or some other animal or something else through the some process. Okay, that is called Internet of IoT. So there are lot of definitions are there, lot of standards are there, many codes are defined the IoT its own manner. But the common meaning of IoT, we can call any device which it is IoT means nothing but if the object can communicate with each other, that means we can call that device or some process, some services may be called as IoT. Okay. So before entering into the IoT, so you know the history of IoT. It is very, very important. Then only you can easily understand where the technology is there. Right? So you may see a lot of movies with the scientific fun and the futuristic science. So here, what about actual history of the science on communicating between the person or communicating the future generation? It is like not like an history. Okay. So it is an important thing. We should know what is the history behind the IoT. So IoT history, it is started from the languages. So before the language, how the human communicated with each other means nothing but producing some regular vocals, some regular signals or vocals like that. They have communicated with the people. Then the evolution of languages came. So then the human want to wrote their history to exhibit their things into the future generation. So there are a lot of procedures were followed from the human. It is started from the inscription. Okay, inscriptions are inscriptions are normally written in the rock, okay, or stone. So where they made some drawing or some text also, right? So it is started from inscription. Then the palm leaf, right? The palm leaf, it has done many recorded history. So Tamil people know very well about the Tholkapiyam. It is 3,000 years back, the literature, the grammatical literature. So still it is available. So the human tried to do something from the starting of era to exhibit their thought or something else to their future generation. So this is a demand. Human need to communicate the people, either present people or futuristic people. Right? So then, so after that, the post, the mail, the exchange of information from one place into another place, it became a great role during the war or some normal purpose. Right? So it is started from Pigan. Right? Pigan, which was used to send the mail. Even in our country, even the Katak, it is in Orissa, where up to 2008 also, the government, central government of post office used the beacon to send the post to the remote villages for effective communication. Also, it was played an important role in natural disaster time. So this is the process the human evolved to communicate with each other. So then the another one, the Anjanam, it is the concept are used in village. So it is not a scientific concept. They have used the trick. They had been used the trick to find out the thing which was stolen or which was theft by someone else. So these are all a lot of concepts were evolved between the human to communicate the people. The basic thing is nothing but the communicate the people, the communicate the content. Okay, that is the data, simply called as data. So finally, the printing press is evaluated in 15th century. So from that, the actual era started to invent a lot of device. Now we are in the IoT. Okay. So then after the printing press, it was invented in 15th century. Then the telegraph, electromagnetic telegraph, it was invented in 1832, which sent the information through the code format, encoded format, to one place into another. So 1844, the first message was sent by the telegraph. Then 1860 to 76, the telephone was invented. Okay, the telephone, the invention of telephone is a big milestone for start the era of communication system in the world. So 1926, the Tesla wrote the concept in an article on wireless communication. Tesla told in this concept, even we can send the object through the wireless. So for that article, he told how we can send the electrical energy from one place into another place without any wire connection. So the first concept of wireless is started in 1926. So after the Tesla, the many people do the research on the computing things. Then the 1950, the Jim computer was invented. So it is it occupied the more phases, more than 1,000 square feet, and the many thousands of wire connections are required to operate the yearly computer. Then the hardware is start to reduce the size and increase its performance due to the lot of inventions, due to the lot of development in the semiconductor device. In 1964, the information system was evolved. 1966, the future of the world is nothing but the computers. All the enterprises were involved in research on the computer. So 1969, the ARPANET, it is the popular project in US to start the project and the network. So after the research of ARPANET in 1969, the lot of network protocols are created, especially the TCP/IP protocol, which is the basic for communicating one computer into another computer, or send the message from one place into another place, either in wire connection or wireless connection. In 1974, after invention of TCP, there is a huge gap to communicate the people using the protocols like TCP/IP protocols. Then the concept of World Wide Web, it evolved in 1989. So after the World Wide Web concept, the growth of networking devices is enormous. It is endless. So in 1990, the Sumatra Poster Mission, which is the important thing of in IoT history. So in 1889, the Coca-Cola machine, vendor machine, is working based on the network connectivity. So the era of IoT is started in 1889. So in 1990, the toaster machine, the automatic toaster machine, which is used to cook the bread. Right? So the 1990, but the people does not aware about the term of IoT. In the 1991, so after the concept, only the web page came 1991. So 1993, the another IoT device, it is like automatic coffee pot. So it is installed in Cambridge University. It captured the picture and it find out the level of the coffee, and it intimate the picture to the server. The people can visualize whether the coffee pot container filled with coffee or not. So 89, 90, and 93. So in these 3 years are important for IoT, but the people were not aware about the name IoT. In 1999, okay, so the 1999 only the name was given like IoT. Okay, so in the 1999, in the presentation happened in the place of University of California, where the first term is introduced 1999 only. So after 1999, the era is evaluated. very enormously. In the 2005, the ITU, International Telecommunication Unit, defined the term of IoT. In the 2005, the Arduino was started their project. In the 2008, they have completed the work, Arduino and Raspberry Pi. A lot of devices are evaluated from 2005 to 2008. So Arduino, you know very well about this, a compact device. It's a small machine. We can do many things. So after 2000, what happened means a lot of network things are developed, especially the GSM. GSM is developed, the GPS, which is used to track the location, the Wi-Fi, then the generation of network from 2G, 3G, and 4G. So all the technologies are developed to support evaluating the IoT. So in the 2008, the first international conference was started, especially for IoT, where a lot of industry experts presented the future of IoT. So it is a milestone, important milestone of IoT, the content in the conference. The 2009, the European community gave some plan of action for developing the IoT. The 2012, based on the plan of action, the global standard was initiated for the IoT. So 2012, the first application is massively used by IoT using RFID tag. So RFID tag, it is, so you can see here, this is called RFID tag. So here you can see the lines, right? These are all lines are nothing but antenna. Okay. So RFID tag, the tag and the reader. So you know about barcode reader. Barcode reader, what it is doing in the supermarket or some other mall. You can see it. It scans the barcode if it is already printed in the particular material, and it shows the prices and lot of details, right? So it is barcode reader. It has some advantage, also some disadvantage. What is the disadvantage of barcode reader? It's nothing but we can't change the data. It is not a flash memory. Flash memory means we can edit the data. Okay, it is a fixed memory. Once you printed the barcode, means we can't change the data from the barcode. But in the RFID tag, it having the tag, it is nothing but sensor. The sensor itself having the antenna, the transmitter and transducer. Okay, transducer means both receiver and sender or antenna. So the RFID tag, it is the first application massively used in IoT. Which it is used to monitoring the location of object, which it is moving from one place into another place. So first, it is used by the Amazon. They are tracking their product for purchasing purpose, and they're tracking the location of a product, also managing the inventory. So a lot of purposes are there. So the RFID tag, it is a, we can say it is a first massive application in IoT, started in 2012. The 2013, there are multiple technologies are developed, like internet in 3G, and a lot of devices from tablet, iPad. So a lot of things are evolved in 2013. So the multiple technologies are supported to evolve the IoT technology. In the 2014, so you can't believe the 65% of electronic goods are in IoT. So still, we don't know what are all devices are IoT, but IoT is available everywhere. The 2014, there is a massive development of IoT. That 2015, what happened means some issues in security, like the mass people are purchasing the devices. So we're changing the protocol, network protocol, from IPv4 to IPv6. So evaluation of IPv6, the deployment process is started again. In the 2016, the more and more technologies are developed in networking side and device side, in electronic side and the hardware side, like that. The 2017, the trends of future is only on IoT, like that, the things are going. In the 2018, there are 22 billions are billions of devices are registered. It is a registered device. It is nothing but double the mobile phone. It's the double the rate of mobile phone the people using in 2018. So in the 2020, 2019 and 2020, a lot of developments are happened in the IoT. So now the trend is going how to make the smart electrical grid system and industry 4.0 for engineer, for civil engineer, how we can constructing the smart home or automated home. There are many disciplines are doing a lot of things in IoT. So let me start with the basic device. It is refrigerator. Okay. So how we can convert the traditional device into IoT? Let you take the refrigerator. The refrigerator purpose is just cools the object. It is the purpose of traditional refrigerator. If we add some computational intelligence. So what is computational intelligence means? It can sense the data from the sensor, and the data can be processed by the microcontroller. The microcontroller produce the result. That result can be actuate some device. It may be displayed in the monitor, or sometimes the data may some devices or stop some devices like that. So it is called the computational intelligence. After evolving of Arduino board, Raspberry Pi, it was the Arduino was released 2008 itself. But there are a lot of lagging in technology side, the infrastructure side. We need to develop the lot of things, right? So now it is a time to adopt IoT to apply. To apply the lot of concept in computational intelligence to get the advanced refrigerator. So now we are adding the connectivity or internet to the computational intelligence. So we can convert that refrigerator into IoT refrigerator. Right? Suppose refrigerator having the sensor of load cell. Load cell is a sensor which it is used to measure the weight. Suppose the weight of the milk can be measured by the sensor, and the data can be processed by the computational intelligence, like Arduino board or Raspberry Pi, or any microcontroller or embedded system can easily process the data from the sensor. And based on the processed data, so it can intimate you are having this much quantity of milk, you are having this much quantity of butter, and you are not closing the door properly, and you are running the refrigerator without any product. So we can give a lot of supportive thing to the refrigerator. The traditional refrigerator, it just cools on object. Manually, you have to check whether your water get freezed or not. So you can reduce the manual work by implementing the IoT technology. So not only this much limitation of refrigerator, right? So after some 2 or 3 years, the social things are evolving, like purchasing capability is evolving through the IoT device. Like suppose, for example, you can order the milk through the online without human aid. So if you are having a refrigerator, it is continuously measure the available milk, available butter, or available other things like vegetables, fruits like that. It can measure the things. we can measure by using either the simple load cell, or we can fit the camera and the camera take the pictures for a particular time interval, and it process whether the particular product is available inside the fridge or quality of the fridge. Everything it can be measured and processed, and it can purchase automatically through the website, like you know, the Big Basket in website, which it is providing the online service for vegetables. Similarly, the refrigerator can order the required product automatically without any human human aid. Okay. So now the refrigerator is called as a IoT refrigerator or smart refrigerator. So let me see the another example, the car. So car, what if a car means just transporting the people? How we can drive the car? We are having the steering. Right? What about the process inside the car? The fuel injector, which it is injecting the fuel dynamically, and depends on the load, the fuel injector should work. Then the lot of processor there. So the modern car having the 50 more than 50 number of devices inside the car to make it a smart car, like ABS, anti-braking system. The anti-braking system is an important device which is used to skidding of the car when you apply the brake suddenly when you're moving with high speed. So what happened in the ABS system? It is nothing but it is pumping the brake. Okay? So if you apply the brake, the ABS system sends the speed of the car and direction of the car and everything. It sends the data from the sensor and it processes the data and it produces the, it applies the brakes like the pulse like brake. So we can avoid the skidding of the car in the normal road. The fuel injector is another important device which it is used in a car. What happened in the fuel injector? The fuel injector is monitoring the speed of the car, load of the car, and according to the load and speed, the opening of fuel is controlled by the fuel injector. Also, fuel injector can monitoring the exhaust. Exhaust should be controlled in a car to avoid the pollution due to the incomplete combustion. So the controlling of fuel is very, very important in your car for its efficient operation. So we are having 50 more devices in your car. For some new car having the option, suppose if car get accident, it automatically alert the emergency service or 108, it call automatically 108 and send the data, and it can speak by own method. So you don't need to call to emergency service, you will get it as soon as possible. It sends the data accurately where the accident is there. So many advantages are there using the IoT in your car, especially in modern car. Then you know the steering, the power steering. So power steering, what is the disadvantage of one of the most disadvantage of power steering? If you move the steering for a long angle, so it may cause to some accident. It can be prevented by the IoT device. So in your car, it is not just like a car to migrate your people. It sensing lot of things, even the fuel. It indicates the quantity of fuel. What about available fuel? So that every data can be sensed in the car. So the modern car having at least 50 more devices to sensing the data and make the comfort zone. So how it is possible means only the simple device. It is called computational intelligence and the network device. Okay. So all these three things combinedly we can make the smart car. So next one is what is the difference between IoT and the computer. So IoT, it is the dedicated, it is a special purpose device. The computer, it's a general purpose. Computer can do many process. It can run the video game. It can run the, it can play the movie, the MP3. So it can run some software. Also the multiple software we can run simultaneously. Okay. This is called computer. Computer is a very big machine. IoT is a tiny machine. So probably you may not see, most of the time you can't see where is the IoT. For example, the computer, what is the size of the processor? It is in some gigahertz, 2 gigahertz, 3 gigahertz. But what about the size of the processor for IoT is in megabytes, some 100 megabytes, some 200 megabytes like that. So the computer is a general purpose device. It not always run the this much bandwidth, like 2 gigahertz or 3 gigahertz. It always running with the small quantity of process only. So it is called less efficiency compared than IoT. So IoT having only the 100 megahertz, but 99% of megahertz it is utilizing by the IoT device. But in terms of computer, it is different. The computer, what it is doing means it can do a lot of things, but how we are using the computer? Okay, it is a big question. The purpose of the computer is different. The purpose of the IoT is different. So IoT is very cheap. We can buy the Arduino device for 500 rupees, and you can buy some sensors for within some 1,000 rupees. Even if you go for temperature sensors, the cost of the temperature sensors is only 50. If you go for load cell, it is some 100 rupees. So within 600 to 700 rupees, we can complete your IoT device. For example, if you take the MP3 player. So MP3 player, it is a special purpose device. It is not a IoT device. Sometimes, suppose the MP3 player is connected with the internet. For example, iPod. iPod can be connected with the internet, so it become the IoT device. So the video gaming machines, even you can use the computer for playing the video game. So for that, you should install the software, video gaming software, and you have to find out the drive, graphics card. The many things are there. But if you buy the video gaming machine, you can simply play the video gaming with the efficient manner. Then the power outage, how much power is utilizing for computer? It is very huge in size. For example, if the watch, if you wristwatch, consuming only less power to show the time. Right? But you can see the time in the computer also, but it consumes a lot of power. Also, the efficiency is very less because of the computer are using the bandwidth of gigahertz. In terms of gigahertz, at least 2 gigahertz. If you go for Intel process, at least 2 gigahertz. Its boards are available. But in case of IoT device, it is very less bandwidth. It is only 100 MP, but efficiency is more. It is using for special purpose. Also, it is compact. IoT devices are very compact, great efficient, and cheap. So next one is the cloud computing. How we can interface IoT to other technology? So now the IoT becoming more powerful. The cloud computing is the huge machine. It is a powerful database in terms of 10 power 16, like that. Okay. 10 power 16 GP, 10 power 28 GP, like that. It is a huge machine where the lot of data are stored. IoT device can be communicate with the cloud server and get the data and process the data and it do some beautiful task. For example, in our cell phone, we are using the widget, like weather widget. So the widget, we can easily monitoring the weather. also the predictions of that can be see through the small application, it is a virtual. So where the data is taken? So the data is stored in the cloud computing. So mass data is stored, can be stored in the cloud, and the IoT can easily access the cloud. And it can do some beautiful tasks like monitoring the weather and movie. The Netflix is another example. We are using the smart TV, can connect the internet, and you can watch the movie from the Netflix or Amazon. It may be. Even the cell phone, in your cell phone, you can watch the TV. So how it is possible means from the cloud system. Similarly, the IoT devices can easily access the cloud to perform well for the particular task. In London, what they are done the thing in IoT, it's nothing but they are using the IoT traffic light system. IoT traffic light system, what it is doing, not only showing the different lights, not only giving the signal whether the vehicle can move or stop like that. So IoT sensing the nameplate, the license plate, and sensing the data, and it gives the particular instruction to the car through the internet from the cloud. So it's monitoring the insurance, available insurance, and what purpose the car is going, where the car is going, and it can monitor, it can communicate with other signals, and it can do the traffic efficiently, clear the traffic efficiently. Suppose the 100 cars coming from one direction, the another direction only 2 cars are coming, means we can easily remove the traffic by adjusting the timing of different lights. So it is already installed in London. So if you are driving the car in the London, you don't worry about the traffic. So it do efficiently the traffic lighting system. Then another thing is the attendance of students can be easily done in the IoT device. It need the RFID tag. RFID tag can easily monitor the movement of students from one classroom into another classroom, and whether they are entering into the classroom on time, the exit. Everything can be monitoring using the RFID, applying the IoT concept. So these are all things only possible by cloud computing. We have cloud computing having a lot of data. For example, if you take the traffic light system, the IoT can take the license, the number plate, data from the number plate, but it have to check with the cloud computing. Then only it can monitoring whether the particular car moving, running with the proper insurance. And also it can sense the direction, where it is coming, where it is going. Okay, what are all, it can easily mapping the route. The cloud is only the backup where it is used for data, the mass data with efficient one. So the cloud technology is very, very important for IoT to deliver a lot of projects for government side and the healthcare side like that. So next one is the social benefits of IoT. The health monitoring system nowadays is growing enormous manner. So the simple pacemaker. So simple pacemaker. Before the pacemaker, what the people are doing is go for surgery. So after the pacemaker, it sends the pulse of the heartbeat, and it produce suppose the pulses are weak, means it produce automatically to keep the proper heartbeat for the people. So nowadays the pacemaker is connected with mobile phone through wireless manner through the IoT device. Not a mobile phone, it's just like monitor. The patient can see the heart rate and whether, at least they can see whether he is he is with the good health or not, or suppose it can notify you need to contact your doctor within particular time. So a lot of process can be done by the IoT device using the computer intelligence and internet connectivity. So it is a very, very important application in the healthcare system. The next one is the during the pandemic situation like COVID-19. So people are staying in the home. They should maintain the social distance, social isolation. So, but we can't stop the economic activity. It is a huge loss for not only the country, for every individual. So there are a lot of plans in future in terms of economical manner. So it can be resolved by IoT devices. So suppose if you are having a smart refrigerator, it can monitoring the available foods in the refrigerator, available raw materials in the refrigerator, and it can order automatically, and we can get it through the online. So we can avoid the direct contact between the humans. So we can reduce the interaction between the humans, and we get a lot of benefits during the pandemic time. So not only the pandemic time, we can save a lot of costs. Suppose if you want to buy the vegetables, buy the milk, buy some raw materials for cooking the food like rice, some other thing. So we need to go in person, right? We need to go in person. Also, we have to monitor the stock available for the particular product. So it is not required if we are having the smart IoT. So it can do its own automatically. It saves a lot of time, also a lot of power. Also, suppose everybody going for supermarket to purchasing the product. So everyone have using the old car. It costs to make more pollution, more wastage of the oil. Like suppose they can order automatically, means it is segregated properly. The door delivery, it is also easily. It has been done. It has been done easily for the people having the smart refrigerator. So it can easily manage the pandemic situation. Not only the pandemic situation, also it can save a lot of cost for fuel. It can save the environment also. Then the online conference, using the IoT, we can do the effective online conference. So we don't need laptop or camera or studio. We don't need a lot of setups. So even the single device, the compact device, can do all this work for online conference with effectively. So we can design our own device. So what are all things are required for online conference? One is monitor, another is camera and mic. Okay. So if you are having the proper camera, and the camera can take the picture and recording the video, the data can be processed. Okay. So not only seeing the picture, not only seeing the video, it can process the data, and it can easily use it to monitoring the students. If you are taking the classes through the online, so now I can monitoring how many people are listening the class. Also, I don't know whether you are receiving my lecture properly or not. Whether it may be making some bore for your mood. So I don't know anything. So I am simply talking in front of camera. Okay, I can't understand what is happening between the students. Okay, so I need the separate team, those team to monitoring the what happened to the live session. They have to inform to me. Then only I can understand. Right. So we can easily design our simple online conference device to reduce a lot of time, right? Suppose to make the meeting, the people come from the different places. Sometimes the people have to come from different countries. So we can save a lot of money, a lot of time if you are making the device using the IoT. Okay. So the internet refrigerator, so it is very simple. If you made the internet refrigerator, you can easily improve the social isolation. Right? So not only this much benefits. So I can divide the four things. One is food, another one is the online conference, then pandemic and health monitoring. So even the agriculture also, we can do a lot of things using the IoT device. You can make the smart pump. The smart pump, which sends the data of moisture content available in the soil and the weather, like the temperature. And it start automatically, and it switch off automatic pump when the enough moisture is available in the soil. So these are all some social benefits are available in the IoT device. Then the another important thing in the IoT devices, there is safety and security. So even the social isolation is required for pandemic situation, but it is not required always, right? Social isolation which stop the interaction between the people. Suppose the things are communicating with each other and doing some tasks. What is the purpose of human, right? They have to interact with each other for their mental health. It is very, very important. So it is one of the risks existing in the IoT. Then safety. The safety means the data. In the IoT device, having the GPS, it tracking the location. IoT device may monitoring your health. IoT device may do some purchase habit. IoT device do some driving activities. It monitoring location and a lot of things. So the track data can be tracked by the third party. Okay, this is a very important risk in IoT. So location can be served in the cloud computing, a common platform, it's a common server. So third party can easily access with some cost. The data can be theft by the third party. So the theft can be easily blocked by firewall. So firewall is the instruction, set of instruction. It is a programming software which can update at time to time. So another important problem in updation. So IoT device is updating means it can't do any process. So suppose the IoT device is monitoring the heartbeat. It is a health monitoring system. So we need to update the IoT device firewall at time to time to protect from the theft, like viral infection on device. Like it is also possible. So every we have to update the firewall to protect the attack of virus from other network things. So the IoT device, when it is updating, means what happened? Suppose in the normal refrigerator, if it is updating the firewall, the normal IoT refrigerator, it is if it is updating the firewall, so it can consume the time. Okay, so it hang out all the, it stop all the regular process and it takes some time to update its software. And then after updating the software, it can perform well. But during the updation, okay, some ideal time is there. Okay, it is very, very important risk for the health monitoring device. The pacemaker should monitoring each and every activity of the heartbeat to do some tasks for keeping the people health and save the lives. So during the update, during the updation of the system, so we need to arrange alternative things for the IoT device. So it is the important thing under the risk. So like that, the embedded device can easily interact with the human. For example, washing machine. You can take the washing machine. It is the best example for embedded system. So what the washing machine, it sends the water, it measures the weight of the water, weight of the cloth, and it automatically switch on, switch off the tap. Okay, so some particular task is doing by the washing machine. So here the washing machine aren't able to directly contact the person. So through the display only it can alarm the user. So after completing the washing machine producing the alarm sound. Okay. So the output device, it may be some speaker. Okay, we need some speaker or sometimes the LED, blinking of LED to alarm the user. Okay. So now embedded devices are similar to IoT device, but with the absence of network connectivity. The embedded device, so you can write the code. Okay. It is having the flash memory. A flash memory means we can change the memory, we can change the data at any time. Okay. So the another important thing, the cost versus efficiency. It is the most important in the embedded system. Cost of the embedded system should be low. For example, the laptop we need to purchase. Means we have to spend at least some 30,000 to 60,000, 70,000 rupees, like that we have to spend. But in case of embedded device, okay, what purpose you are going to purchasing the laptop? So some people purchasing the laptop for playing the game alone. So it is the cost versus efficiency. If you see for playing the game in the laptop, it is not a good, right? Suppose if you go for a gaming device, the cost of the gaming device around some 5,000, 3,000, 6,000, like that. Also the efficiency. The efficiency means we are effectively using the machine. That is efficiency. Suppose if you are using the gaming device, video gaming device for playing the game, means 100% the device is dedicated for playing the game, right? But in case of using the laptop, so what happened? Laptop consumes a lot of power, and a lot of device should be run by the laptop. So what about the processor? Processor speed is occupy only some 1 GB or 500 MB only, but the processor for gaming laptop, it may be some 4 GHz length. So the embedded device is simply the compact. It is hidden from the normal user. Okay. So the layman can easily understand any machine doing some particular task, means that machine having some embedded system. For example, the washing machine, MP3 player, video gaming, like that. So the benefit of the embedded device is compact. Suppose if you are going to add some internet connectivity, and based on the internet connectivity, if you are doing some task, means the embedded devices is called as IoT devices. So next one is the applications of IoT. So applications of IoT, we can divide it into two things. One is industry IoT, another one is consumer IoT. So in the industry IoT, there are a lot of things are there. In the industry IoT, it is started from the smart grid. Okay, smart grid, it is a emerging field for managing the power producing from the different power system. So most of the case, what is going now, the power plant is running with very less efficiency because of managing the power system during the grid. So you know what is the grid, what grid is doing. So the grid is taking the electricity from power station and supplying to the consumer. So there are a lot of number of power stations are there. The power stations are running with either full capacity or almost it is always running 80% of capacity. Suppose one power plant, the capacity is 1 MW. Right? So it is always run with some 0.8 MW or 0.9 MW. But what about consumer? Okay. Electricity, we can't save it like money. So electricity is always producing by the power plant. It is replacing by the consumer. So the daytime, the consumers are using a lot of electricity, but in the nighttime, it may not. Like, suppose in the pandemic time, it is not required to run the power plant with the fully loaded. So what happens if you are running the power plant fully loaded? Efficiency is reducing, right? So not only efficiency, it wasting the manpower, it wasting the raw material because of the coal, like raw materials are it is limited only, right? So we should not waste the cost also. Also the cost of the electricity is also increasing. It damages the environment. A lot of things are there. So if you are making the smart grid using the IoT, we can easily reduce the cost of the power plant. Also reduce the efficiency, manpower. We can produce the electricity with very cheap cost. So electricity, we can divide into two things. One is renewable, one is non-renewable. So renewable energy, renewable electricity means nothing but getting from some solar, wind, biomass, or land like that. So these are all called renewable electricity. Then the conventional electricity, conventional power plant, like a thermal power plant like that. These are all called as conventional power plant. So the renewable system is not running always. So only the daytime, only the solar power is available. Also the another side, the consumer need a lot of electricity. So this is a huge gap between demand and the production. So that's why we are going for the conventional power plant, right? Suppose the renewable system, we have to use 80%, okay? We have to use 80% of renewable energy. So some 20% we can go for. So it is called a capacity factor. Okay. So capacity factor means how much capacity of the power plant is utilized for the group of people or country in a year. It is called capacity. Suppose a point capacity factor is 80% means in a year, the 80% of electricity is producing by renewable sources. Okay, if the capacity factor 20 for conventional power plant means for a year, only 20% of electricity is utilized by the from the power plant, the conventional power plant, like coal power plant, thermal power plant, like that. So the renewable energy, the renewable side, what is the current scenario means? It is reverse. So renewable capacity is only 20%. But conventional power plant, 80%. So what's the danger for this inefficient scenario is nothing but the smartness of grid. Okay. So grid can easily, if the grid is smart, it can easily take the decision. And it can easily supply the required electricity to the consumer from the power. Right. So there are some other applications are there, the smart logistics. The smart logistics, it is very simple. The RFID tag, all the object having the RFID tag. So now what they are doing, the people are seeing the address and segregating the mails or parcel and the goods. And the manually segregating. It takes a lot of time. It needs a lot of manpower. Sometimes the mistake may be possible due to the manual error. So suppose every object have its own RFID, so it can automatically segregate. So all the airports, the luggages are easily managed by the RFID tag. So then the smart transport, can intimate the availability of seat to the consumer. Also intimate the location, how long it takes. So a lot of things we can do it using the smart, machines, like
Assistant Professor of EEE Department. And first of all, I would like to thank our chief guest, Professor Murthy sir, for giving a wonderful and splendid information on IoT. It was a very useful webinar, sir. And most of us have gained a lot of knowledge from it. And I also thank all the participants to patiently listening over the webinar for the complete webinar and making it as a grand success. I also want to mention our management who have been completely supporting us with this kind of webinars. Our principal, Dr. Abhidani, and our HOD, Mr. Firmness Raj, have been throughout the thing for conducting such a webinar. And also, I want to inform all the participants that in our college, we are giving these kind of webinars in a regular manner, as lots of research activities are going on in our campus. And I want to share you the details, like I'm going to share you the social media pages and links for our college, such that you can be updated about the latest innovations and research that is happening in our college. You can also get the webinar links and some workshop links through this, brochures, everything you can collect through it. I'll also share it in the chat page for your reference. Yes. You can always follow. You can always follow these pages and subscribe to these pages to get the latest information from our college. And I have also posted the feedback link in our Facebook page. Triply Facebook page and SCADA College of Engineering and Technologies Facebook page. You can also utilize this link from the page. That'll be